Because Tsantsabane is special place in a sense that there is manganese here, there is iron ore here, there are all types of minerals. Maraluna, you don't benefit anything out of those minerals. So these mines undermine you because they think you can't do anything to them. But with government of the EFF that is not scared of the mines, we will be with you to make sure that the mines do good, because they promised to do so when they were applying for licenses. So we are here to say all of these mines must employ our people and pay them proper wages, and they must give them medical aid, and they must give them pension fund, so that the jobs in the mines are guaranteed and jobs in the mines are paying very well. How come we don't have a TVET college, or in schools we are not taught mining, yet our economy in Siyanda is mining? Our syllabus must always be relevant to what is relevant to our economy. In that way, we don't grow up as spectators. Re shebile batho ba maina, banka manganese ka ditraka, banka iron ore ka ditraka, without anyone challenging them. So we need a government that is going to say, no iron ore or manganese is going to leave Tsantsabane. We want you to beneficiate here. Because when they beneficiate here, then they create jobs here. You must know all of these minerals, when they leave, it's in the finished goods. How Sheba Traka Elicite Manganese, you must know Utamaya Misebeti Yaluna in that track. That's why here Richards Bay, from Richards Bay, it goes out of the country, it comes back as a finished product. We need to create jobs through beneficiation. We need to re-industrialize this area. We need to open all the factories that have closed so that you can get jobs next to where you stay. In Cape Town and all of Western Cape, textile industry used to create a lot of jobs. Today, it has collapsed. And today, our people are given fake goods from China, India, and everywhere else. And that has undermined the textile industry. An industry that used to employ 150,000 people, today, textile industry only employs 80,000 people. It shows you that we are deindustrializing in South Africa. We are not industrializing. If we employed in the industry 150,000 people, and today we are employing only 8 people, therefore, the industry is shutting down. Not so long ago, they said to us, 3-4 days ago, that manufacturing in South Africa has declined with 6.4%. Manufacturing is jobs. It used to be the biggest contributor to our GDP, in a contributor 24%, 24.4%. Today, it contributes 14%, which means manufacturing has declined. And when manufacturing declines, people lose jobs. So today, we want to grow the economy so that we create jobs. It's not a joke. Anyone who says to you, but bako Zimbabwe, libakae balinkela misebetsi, is talking nonsense, because he must tell you, bankile misebetsi ya factory e yebai butsing ko kai. Agere, there must be a factory open first before people take jobs. So there is no factory that is open. Which job did they take? Where? The economy is stuck. And with a stuck economy, you can't produce jobs. And Ramaphosa has got no plan on how it's going to grow the economy. We are saying we are going to grow the economy by industrializing. And when you industrialize, then you create jobs. How do you industrialize? You beneficiate in South Africa. Chrome that is moved from Limpopo to Richards Bay to China and comes back as a finished product in a form of steel, it must come to an end. Iscor used to be the biggest steel company. Today is going to retrench not less than 3,000 people. There was a company in Witbank of steel which closed down and closed 5,000 jobs. Today, post office is going to retrench more than 3,000 employees. Someone says to you, people are taking jobs. There are no jobs being taken. There are jobs being lost in the economy because the economy is not growing. We must grow the economy. You grow the economy when you invest in infrastructural development. So infrastructural development will mean, amongst other things, you must develop a big infrastructure for sewer so that batho ba go maranteng le bona ba ska ba le sewer e mathanko strateng, because you did not build a proper infrastructure for our people. So infrastructure ye re thotseng ha re ne re nka from apartheid, it was a small infrastructure meant for whites only. Now we've plugged in our people. The plugging in of our people means we must expand that infrastructure. There is no area in Siyanda or Tsantsabane which will not have investment if you build roads. Every place where you can build proper roads, a mall is going to be opened there. A shopping complex is going to be opened there. A factory will be opened there. How can someone go and open a factory in a place where there is no road? Or no, Nagibata Ubula factory where there is no road. All of those trucks that are going there are going to be broken down because there is no proper road. You build roads, you create jobs, you grow the economy, you give people reliable water. Not this water shedding. Reliable water that is running 24/7, then people will come and invest in that economy. Today, unalebutata ba water shedding motsantsabane, metsi a tsamaya for a week or more, but ba rona ba ba unfortunate, ba na le di flushing toilet, ha di flush because metsi ha te. So re batla ntwe ya water shedding motsantsabane e fele. We make a sure but baruna bakriamit. So you must give our people electricity. Once you give every household electricity, once you kill load shedding, then you are guaranteed investment. Investment is jobs. These people, when we say to them, you must beneficiate here in Tsantsabane, in Kurman, in Kimberley, they are going to say to me, where will we get the electricity? Because to produce steel, you need a lot of electricity. And in South Africa, there is load shedding. There is nothing we can do. We have to take these things out. So to shut that down, you must provide reliable electricity and stop the load shedding. Then investors know there is reliable water, there is reliable electricity, proper roads, and proper sewer systems in place. They will come no maganjan, because anyway, they want this manganese. They will come and stay here. Once they stay here, it means a new township development. And once you attract a middle class in your municipality, that's when the municipality start generating income to be able to provide services to our people. So fighters, all of that can be done by the EFF. I mean, why are we not producing koloi, a vehicle, the motor car that moves on the road? South Africa doesn't produce its own car. koloi, mara re producer a fighter jet called Ray Falk. So fighter jet it means fly machine. Because we can make a machine to go and fly high there, but we can't make the machine to move on the road. That doesn't make sense. If we can make it fly, we can make it move. And why are we not producing our own cars in South Africa? Because when you produce cars in South Africa, you are already guaranteed market in Africa. The Nigerians constitute a quarter of the African population. They've got money. They are one of the big economies in South Africa. We can supply them with cars. And when we supply them with cars, we're creating jobs in South Africa. We can't produce cars. Why? ANC is signing an agreement. Le Germany, le Japan, le UK, or Bona Matla producer di koloi, Renata di Reka from Bona. That's why Kaofela Luna Lula Levata, Mercedes Benz, Levata BMW, you want a German machine because that is the only thing that gets supplied to us by the Germans. We can do better than the Germans. What they do, they produce cars. They say, oh, now EFF is making noise. Okay, we will no longer assemble these cars in Germany. We'll bring the parts to South Africa and then you will assemble them. It's not enough. We need to start a car from scratch. And that way, we are going to create a lot of jobs. There's going to be a car produced by South Africa under the EFF, and that car will be in demand. And when it is in demand, jobs will be created. Comrades, I always ask them, why are we not having a speed train from Johannesburg to Cape Town? But no, harna chelet. But we don't have to have money to do a speed train. China has done speed trains, many of them, in China. You say to them, you go and sign what we call BOT, Build, Operate, Transfer. You say to China, I don't have money, but I've got customers. Come and build a speed train in South Africa. It's yours. Operate it for 30 years. After 30 years, you give it back to me as South Africa. Imagine if we said that in 1994. This year is 30 years. They will be handing over that speed train to South Africa without South Africa spending a cent on building a speed train. Comrades, Afrikaners, when they were growing the apartheid economy, they built railway lanes. These railway lanes that you see, it was built by Afrikaners. Not a single one of them was built by the ANC. How are you going to create jobs when you can't even build one single railway lane? Railway lane, ibata bat babangata when you build it. That's where they employed illiterate Afrikaners that time. Hauna bana banale ntongo barke Spoornet. Banale bo Transnet yona eo. Ke bona nna ba etsa di train di railway lane. Mo di train di totsa mante. Today we took government. We don't expand on the railway lanes that we found. If anything, we shut down the railway lanes that we found. There was a long distance train from Johannesburg to East London. There was a long distance train from Johannesburg to Cape Town, to Musina, to Durban. Today, there is no single one. The ANC has closed down long distance trains because they don't know how to run the business of government. The long distance train are the safest model of transport. If you put security there, you secure those trains, a person travels from Johannesburg to Cape Town without an accident. Today, our people are dying on the roads in Easter during festive seasons because abana alternative means. They can't afford aeroplanes. And on the road, they are squeezed in Siaya taxis like sardines. We cannot have that. We have to give our people alternative mode of transport. You do that, you grow the economy, you create jobs. So you can't say there are no jobs, but you are not building any big construction work. Big construction work speaks about work like Midupi Power Station, Kusile Power Station. With Midupi Power Station alone, in Lephalale, that town grew and became big and attracted middle class. It's one of the best municipalities. Why? Because there is Midupi Coal Power Station. That was built by Mbeki. Even now, it's not fully commissioned. But fighters, what is it that we have done in the past 6 years, which is a big construction work of government that involves billions? Because in the absence of construction, there will not be jobs. So you have nothing big that you are constructing. There is no big road that you are constructing. There is no big railway lane that you are busy with. But you say you want to create jobs. Only those who think will be able to create jobs.